zero hour, 9 a.m. And I'm gonna be high as a kite by then. I'm
everybody. Thank you for coming out tonight. So let me give a quick update on the whole reason that we're here. John Stack was in a pretty horrific motorcycle accident back in upstate New York a couple of weeks ago. And the good news is that he's going to be out of intensive care and he's going to be up and walking pretty soon. So that's the good part of this. So let's start this out on a positive note. Now we've got special guests who are coming here. And this first band is a band that we've wanted to play with for a very long time. And let me just tell you that the reason that they're here is they used to come to our shows at the Orange County Fair. And what was great is they'd come up to us and they'd say, hey guys, we love your band and we make sure that we don't play on the nights that you guys are playing the OC Fair. They're dedicated and they loved John Stack when he was the Which One's Pink lead guitar player. So we've invited them down here to open this show and to start it off by kicking you right in the teeth. So get ready for Damage Inc.
Killing you! name Saki's game. Master! Oh yeah!
Master.
Master!
Thank you.
Did I mention that that's a tribute to Metallica? Some things, I've been running around like a head with my chicken cut off all day trying to arrange things, so if I miss a few things, please forgive me. When news broke that we were going to put on this benefit concert, I was contacted by this next guy who said some things with some colorful language that I won't repeat. But when he got the opportunity to come in and sit in with Damage Inc. and do the Queen song Stone Cold Crazy, his response was very intense. That's the best I can say here. So what you're gonna hear now is a combination that I've dreamed of for a very, very long time, and that is Mike McManus from Queen Nation sitting in with Damage Inc. doing Stone Cold Crazy.
Dreaming I was Al Capone. Rumor going round, gotta clear out of town. Smell like a dry fish bone. Here come the law, gonna break down the door. Carry me away once more. Never, never, never want it anymore. Gotta get away from the stone cold floor. Crazy, stone cold crazy, yo. Tommy gun, here come the deputy, try fucking get me, gotta fucking get up and run, they got these sirens, I'll run right out of juice, they're gonna put me in a cell if I can't go to heaven, let me go to hell, crazy, stone cold crazy, yo!
Man, that was even better than I dreamed of. And that was an intense dream that I have, you know what I mean? All right, so while we change over and go into the next band, I want to talk a little bit about our silent auction items over here. We have a selected few items, some really good stuff. One of the key items that we have up for bid is right up here on the stage, over here by Chris Knight, which is a white Fender Stratocaster replica that was built by Paul Samron for use and used by Paul Samron in Which Wants Pink for 2011 to 2014. It is what we call game-used gear. So get in there and make your bids right now. We have three separate ticket packages to Which Wants Pink. We have our September 16th show here at the Canyon Club. We have our August 12th show up at the Libby Bowl in Ojai if you've come that far. And we have our August 26th show at the Saban Theater in Beverly Hills. And the great thing about it is you don't just get tickets, but we have t-shirts, hats, some other tchotchkes that are gonna be in there. So come in and make a bid on that stuff. The Canyon Club has been good enough to give us tickets to some of the upcoming shows at the Canyon Club in the Saban. We have some packages over here. We have some professional audio gear that you should check out. If you're a musician and you want some high quality audio gear at a reasonable price, this is the place to get it. How are we doing back here, guys? A few more minutes? All right. So yeah, you know, I'm paid to talk, but I'm not paid to entertain. So, and you'll find that becomes very clear as I struggle on through the night with thinking of something to say. But let me talk to the live stream people out there. This is being broadcast all across the world via live stream right now. And we're hoping that John Stack and his family are all at home watching this incredible night that we've put together in a very short order. So let me say hi to you people on the East Coast. Let's say hi to the people down in Australia from Pink Floyd's A Fleeting Glimpse website. They publicized this. Yeah. The people from Neptune Pink Floyd in the United Kingdom, they've publicized this. Damian Darlington, the lead guitar player for Brit Floyd, has publicized this. So we've got a lot of support out there from the Pink Floyd community. And of course, John Stack's friends and family back there on the East Coast, we're giving them a taste of what his friends were able to offer out here on the West Coast. And later on, Which One's Pink's gonna be out here, and we're gonna do a full set, and it's going to include The Dark Side of the Moon in its entirety. And that was Steve Zukowski. Steve Zukowski, as you may remember, was a member of Which One's Pink. Played alongside John Stack for the better part of a decade. Mike McManus is going to stay up here and play a song. Then Scott Richards from Which One's Pink is going to play the bass. And back there in the drum kit is Jim Kersey, formerly of Led Zeppelin, and one of the best drummers that I've ever seen in my life. And we've invited our friend Alex Cabrera, who has donated his time to come out here and sing a very challenging song. And I heard it in soundcheck. He does a great job. And they're going to do for you a very appropriate song for John Stack, the Queen song, Keep Yourself Alive.
But I never saw my face any window any day. Well, they tell you, folks, I'm telling you, be a superstar. When I tell you, just be satisfied, stay right where you are, keep yourself alive, yeah. Ooh, take your time and take my money, keep me satisfied. Body and my soul, well, I grow a little bigger, maybe that will be my goal. I was told a million times by the people in my way, I had to keep on trying and get better every day. But if I crossed a million rivers and I rode a million miles, well, I'd still be where I started, same as where I started. Keep yourself alive, keep yourself alive. Take you all your time and money, keep me satisfied.
say?
No, I just think I'm two steps nearer to my grave.
Keep yourself alive, yeah, keep yourself alive. Take more time and take my money, keep me satisfied. Keep yourself alive, keep yourself alive. All you people, keep yourself alive. Keep yourself alive, keep yourself alive. Take you all your time and money, keep me satisfied. Keep yourself alive, keep yourself alive. All you people, keep yourself alive. Take you all your time and money, honey, you will survive. Keep yourself alive, keep yourself alive.
Never has that band played together until just this second. Amazing. And by the way, Steve Zukowski, I met when he was in a Queen tribute band called Sheer Heart Attack. And he basically midwifed Which One's Pink into existence. So for him and Mike McManus of Queen Nation to play together, that's a once-in-a-lifetime thing. But, you know, maybe they'll form a band out of this experience, and we'll have incredible Queen all the time. All right, so, yeah, we do have a singer. All right, so now I am pleased to bring out one of John Stack's really good friends, a guy who's got pipes you won't believe. He's from Seattle, but he used to live down here in Los Angeles. His name is Sean Daly. Give him a hand. And now what you're going to hear is Steve Zukowski and Jim Kersey reuniting as part of Led Zepp again with Scott Richards, who sat in with Led Zepp again many times. And they're going to do for you Good Times, Bad Times.
Thank you.
Yeah. We're going to hear a little bit more from Mr. Sean Daly in a little bit. But again, this band didn't even sound check that. They just met each other backstage a few minutes before and came out and rocked your world with that one. I think it's pretty amazing. What do you think? All right, so here we go. So our next act is going to do something that is very appropriate for me, maybe less appropriate for John. And Mr. Dennis Neal here is the Neil Young tribute guy in Southern California and across the country. And he's going to play a song with Scott Richards from Which One's Pink, and Jim Kersey from Led Zeppelin Again, formerly thereof, Mr. Alan Moreno from Which One's Pink, Mr. Nick Fidesca on a very challenging part from Which One's Pink, and Larry Eisenberg from Which One's Pink. So sit back, get ready, relax to the strains of Old Man.
Thank you, Dennis.
And now I'm going to do it. Old man, look at my... I would never inflict that on you. I saved that for my wife. Where is she? So we're going to take a couple of minutes here to get the stage set up. And I'm going to tell a couple of stories. But before I do, I want to encourage everybody who's out there on the live stream. If you can't be here tonight, please go to the GoFundMe page for the John Stack and Family Medical Bills Fund and donate whatever you can. I don't care if it's $5, $1.98, $1.50, or $100. Anything helps. This is really important that John gets enough donations to help sustain him while he's on this very long, difficult road of rehabilitation. So I'm encouraging all of you out there in the internet to please step forward and help us help John. Also, for those of you who are here, thank you so much for buying the tickets. 100% of the ticket price is going to the John Stack Fund. However, if you're feeling so inclined, we have a donation box here at the silent auction table. So wander up there and drop a 5, a 10, a 20, or a Benji in the box and help make this a really big night for John. Now, for those of you who don't know me, I come from a city called Hawthorne, California. It's down by the airport. It's the home of the Beach Boys. And before that, I lived in Inglewood, and I watched the Forum being built. And I can tell you this, I became one of the biggest Los Angeles Laker fans that this country has ever known. Unfortunately, John Stack is a Boston Celtics fan. Now I'm going to do something that I would never, ever, ever do for anybody else. I'm going to do it right here, right now. I'm taking off an item of clothing. Now, I know number 4, Jason Terry, is not a huge part of the Celtics' legacy, but I hate him anyway. This hurts me. But I want you all to know that this is how far I'm willing to go to support John Stack and his recovery rehabilitation, and I want you all to go as far as I have and do something that hurts. Part with some cash in that donation box. All right. So guess what we've got coming up now? We've got some John Stack original material being played. So behind me, we have on guitar a man known as the mighty John Achenbach. And behind him, in this really cool tank top, is a gentleman I've never met. And his name is Darren Householder, but I've been assured that he's gonna kick our butts. And then over here in this cheesy fedora is a gentleman who is a smoking man on the low end bass, and that's D-Breaks, Derek Brakefield. And then back on the drums, who's still down there, got his head between his knees, is a gentleman by the name of Garrett Smith, a longtime friend of John Stack. All these guys are longtime friends of John Stack. And we're gonna welcome back for some vocals, singing Tell the World How I Died by Choking Ghost, Mr. Sean Daly.
All right, this is a classic Choking Ghost song.
We'll be right back.
Coming up for another one.
Wow. So there is a gentleman, I think he's here tonight, who is responsible for the fact that we even know who John Stack is. This guy approached me at a strip club in Pasadena, where Which Ones Pink was playing a show back in the late 90s. And he slipped me a CD that said Choking Ghost on it. Then what the hell's that? He says, I'd love to have them open for you sometime. And I said, well, okay, blah, blah, blah. So a couple weeks later, I found out that they had got an opening slot for Which Ones Pink at 14 Below in Santa Monica.
Got everything that's on
And that was Paul Samarin of Which One's Pink doing a cover of Numira's song, Slow Burn. So John Stack had two bands that we know of, Choking Ghost and Numira. So you just heard the one song by each of those. So let me finish the story. He forces this CD into my hand. I'm like, well, whatever, dude. And then I found out that they were going to open for us at 14 Below in Santa Monica. So I put the thing in my CD player. Remember those? And I listened to it and I said, holy shit, that is one rocking song. So, or one rocking CD. It was unbelievable. And I made it a point to go out and see Choking Ghost at 14 Below before they opened for us. And at that show, they sang a Pink Floyd medley. And I said, oh my God. So I started making plans to recruit John into the band then. Took a couple of years. That's how he ended up in Which One's Pink. Because Harry Mike came up and gave me a CD at a strip club. So now, again, I want to emphasize that I have a donation box here. There's one over there at the merch booth, which we don't have any merch for sale, but you have auction items. So come over here, drop some cash into the box. It won't hurt, I promise. Go over there, drop some cash into the box. What we have coming up for you is an offshoot of Which One's Pink with some of our best players in it doing some really cool stuff, R&B, funk, and this guy right here behind me, Alan Moreno, is sort of the band leader of this outfit that goes by the name of Diez Manos. And they consist of Nick Fidesca from Which One's Pink on keyboards, and Jorge Villanueva on drums, and the aforementioned Derek Brakefield on bass. Now, when I said that his fedora was cheesy, I lied. I think it's really cool. And he's so much better looking than I am.
It's not a fedora. It's a pork pie, Dan. I thought you were from the 80s, dude.
I don't know anything about no ska bands like the Untouchables that Derek was the bass player in for many years. I don't know anything about fashion. That's obvious. And
that's why I love you, Dan.
I don't like him saying that when he's standing behind me. But in any event, also part of this organization is Natalie Azarad, or Natalie Rudkin, of Which One's Pink. You guys may hear her a little bit later when we do The Dark Side of the Moon in its entirety. So now, are we ready? Please sit back and welcome Diez Manos.
If you want my loving, All right. Thank you all for coming out. You know, I can speak for a few people in the house. We love John Stack, and there's nothing more than we could do to support him. But there's one thing I can say right now is let's all be careful, y'all, while we're driving, while we're doing all this stuff, because it wouldn't have happened if a motherfucker wasn't texting while they hit that motherfucker from the back. So without being preachy, let's just all look out for each other and let's just watch what we're doing. Amen.
I beg your pardon. Walk the straight and narrow track. If you walk with Jesus, better save your soul. No, you got to keep the devil way down. Got the fire and fury at his command. No, you don't have to worry if you hold on to Jesus' hand. We'll be all safe from Satan.
Way down in a hole.
and we're going way down in a hole.
Derek Brakefield, y'all. Yes, we love John Stack. Thank you, everybody, for showing up for John Stack. It's a very special night. I'm really proud to be here with these guys and Which One Speak and all of his friends. Thank you for supporting him. We're going to do a song by Etta James that I really especially love. It's called I'd Rather Go Blind. Here we go. 'cause I would rather be.
Y'all, come on, let's give it up. You go, girl.
We'd love to invite April on stage and Sharon. Woo! Anyone else who would like to sing with us? Come on up.
Where's Dan Johnson when we need him?
Dan Johnson.
Scott Richards.
Christina.
Who's looking for me?
The guy with the fedora.
That's a baseball cap.
All right.
Oh my God, I've been requested to sing with them. Woo!
You guys too. Sing with us.
guys so much. We appreciate it.
We love you. We love you, John Stack.
This is our Agoura Hills debut. Glad to share it with you.
All right. Quick announcement. Anybody who's played tonight or is going to play tonight, get up here on stage right now. We're going to take a photograph. All right? We need you to move with alacrity. It's a big word. Hi, Sherilyn. Did you see April back there singing background vocals? Hey, this isn't just about John Stack. It's about the whole Stack family, and we're proud to support them. And by the way, if you saw back there, we had background singers Scott Richard, Sharon, whose last name I can't pronounce, my wife, April McMillan Johnson, and me. Did I ruin it? I thought so. If you're in the crowd, please step up to the mic.
Only some of us smell bad.
Hands up!
All right, stick around. We're going to take a few minutes to change everything over. We'll come back with a nice set from Which One's Pink, including The Dark Side of the Moon in its entirety. All right? Bid on the items, please. That's all we ask. Bid on the items. Or stuff cash into that box. I don't care which one you do. Do it. Do both.